side already. Very, I feel like Dom wants...
No, but he's got a few items.
Yeah. I think from the mid lane. Got a bit of a fight down here.
Yeah, bottom side actually working out here as well, as Beryl does a hell of a lot of work. Def down to 200. Pyosik not in any position to help this one.
Look at Canyon.
Oh my goodness, lying in wait. Will have Beryl coming up, but it'll be spotted on this control ward. Pyosik not going to get hit by that Q. Immediate reaction, actually really like that. The Gromp is going to be taken, level 4 claimed by Pyosik. Now we've got a bit of a flamethrower here. And Ghost is pretty low, actually.
Canyon's just not leaving this jungle. He's like, everything is mine. Is he really going to grind for that?
Fight is going to come in. Flash has to come out, as maybe they've caught on to Chovy. But the value of this Braum is so high. First Blood goes over to Chovy on his Sylas. That's going to save him so much. As finally, Showmaker's going to be able to grab a kill, but I think it's the sacrifice of his life. He's trying to get out, grabs another flash, and I actually think that that's it. Showmaker's going to be able to make it to safety. So, 2-for-1 in favor of DRX, but Showmaker somehow escapes.
Doran didn't pick up a cull or anything like that. He's not going ultra. They're going to engage.
That arrow is going to come down, ignite onto Death, who flashes away immediately. Gets a bit of damage back, has his Severum in case anyone tries to dive, but Showmaker's going to come in here looking for more. DRX are just going to back the heck away from this lane. And oh no, Pyosik probably pretty unfortunate timing here as Sylas is still in the mid lane. Ignite to go down. Bubble's going to land. As, Pyosik's just dead. I don't know why he was sticking around. Def trying to get some damage in here. Onslaught doing some work, but not quite enough as Chovy gets on in. Beryl going to find the Sylas. Carrier moving on over as well. The Lee Sin throws his life away, but maybe it's in the benefit of his team, and it is. Cue the yakety sax, Valdez. This game is going to hell in a handbasket.
Oh man, that was pretty insane the way that all started off. I'm not sure why Chovy was so late to the fight. He must have been cleaning up a really big wave that Showmaker got in there. As here comes Nuggery.
Yep, Slicing Maelstrom is going to be the answer here. Doran trying to avoid the damage. He has Flash. Looking to stack up these Marks of the Storm, and Lightning Rush is going to get him to safety. So, Nuggery pressed a lot of buttons. He's a big old bear. Well, Caitlin Cogmore, as our friend LS would say, has been equipped here by Deft, so scary guns to go up against.
Oh, Beryl.
There's the face check. It's not what you want, but that Q's going to miss out a carrier. Beryl's going to be absolutely fine. Still has the E, I believe, to keep himself alive, and Deft misses yet another Q as well from his Calibrum. Meaning that Beryl is going to be pretty healthy, pushing this wave towards the outer turret bottom lane. Oh, Chovy. Okay. Just absconds his way out.
I thought maybe Canyon would drop the Rift Herald down here, but maybe he wants to wait for Cloudrake. I'm not sure if you really need to get this Bulbasaur to Fed. I mean, he's kind of just be sitting there as another engage.
Yep, Pyosik. Perry's going to land that Winter's Bite, throws down the ulti, is now Beryl trying to mitigate some of this damage. And the AoE is just huge coming out from Damwon. Pyosik having to leave. Carrier has to flash, and Chovy off to the side. Picks himself up a man drop, and we'll see whether he does come in with it, but Deft is just taken down. Ghost's going to be able to lock that one up, and Pyosik's going to flash, but I have a feeling that this burn damage is going to be enough. One last tick, no.
Down. We're just waiting. Okay.
Okay. Well. Arrow right underneath the turret.
There's
the man drop. Immediate exhaust onto Beryl. As Deft is wondering what he's actually supposed to do here, as Carrier does do a fair bit of damage. Deft with his Severum trying to get the work done. Should be able to get it as the flash forward. Beryl, 1v2, takes down the Aphelios, and now Chovy misses the arrow, misses the abduct. I want out of here, Valdez. This is not, it's not what I signed up for. As now he's just getting kited. You did not want to hit that one, Chovy, as
Ghost.
He flashes in.
Oh, no, dear.
That's a yikesy play as Doran now gets a flashback underneath his turret, but Kenya's still going to be able to put him down. Pyosik up here, 1v2 now, has himself a turret, still going to go down, and Damwon are going to win this game.
In that blue side jungle, they have won every single fight that has come to them there. And you can see the setup, they're calling for it. Just a little bit of poke damage from Ghost. He can't exactly walk past because they see Chovy coming down, and it eventually just ends up it's only Beryl. So Ghost has to abandon him. And Beryl's like, I don't know.
My shield's better than yours, basically.
Yeah.
Talking to Carrier there.
And I assume he did die eventually. I don't see him on the map. Here's this play up in the top side. Canyon, really nice kick. He's able to land the Q follow up, and Bulbasaur's so hard to kill. Toxic, you know, you can subjugate, you can do a bit of damage. But this is the trade that, that was most interesting for me.
Oh, yeah, 살았다, 살았다, 잡혀.
Dodges everything. He's like, I'm alive, I'm alive.
Yo, 잠깐, 내가 딱 끌게. 야, 잡았어. 야, 나이스. 어딜 이따 치기.
For DRX to work another one of their miracles in this particular game. All right, in goes Chovy, looking for Ghost here, wanting to get some revenge. I don't know whether he's going to be able to, as this man drops a plenty. And Ghost is now safe. Carrier very, very low as Noggery, trying to flash his way out. Deft is doing a lot of damage, but Doran now might be the savior of his team. Two kills for the top laner of DRX. And Showmaker trying to pick up the stragglers will find himself. As Noggery is looking to take away the red buff. Carrier is here. And Chovy's going to move on in as well. Does find himself the ultimate there as Noggery now trying to get himself out. Did manage to steal the red, but is he going to be able to make it out with his life? As Deft is very long from this fight. Eventually will turn up, but unable to actually start the battle that they were looking for. Now Chovy could be in trouble. Has to flash to get himself out of this one as Ghost now without the arrow. And Shirley gets a little bit confused on her way down the lane, so isn't going to be able to get too much value on this inner turret. DRX still very, very low. Only really Deft that hasn't suffered a few injuries in the last little while as that bubble was just collected by the cannon.
Yeah.
Skystrike layered on top is actually pretty good damage.
Even Volibear's got some poke, man. He's getting in there. He's a bear, but he can call down the God of Thunder to help him out. And you can see what happens when the Ash and the Zoe get ahead of the relatively low range from the side of DRX. I mean, Aphelios can only do so much. And the amount of poke that they're able to throw out and just, well, here we go.
In goes Doran, just takes the front door as Beryl survives for so damn long. But Doran is going to go gold, trying to keep himself up. Chovy as well.
Oh,
but they just lose the cannon. They lose the Sylas. Now Deft has to flash. The Q was very close from Kenny, but he's still on the chase. As now Showmaker will find his double kill. And Noggery's there as well. This is the dumb one we were expecting to see. This should be the result in a 2-0, right? But we'll be going to a game three as Showmaker picks up yet another one. And he's feeling himself. Absolutely had to do that as the rest of DRX are lying in wait. The Infernal Drake going to be up in 10 seconds time. The Aphelios is absolutely not going to be in the right position, though, as okay, now they may have found Showmaker looking for Ghost now as they immediately change their minds. Chovy picks himself up a kick. Will he be able to grab the kill? Yes, they do manage to take down the Ash, but Deft can't even get to this fight. Doesn't really matter, though. They've won it. 2-for-1 at the moment as Showmaker decides to just jump on in to see what's going on, discovers that he doesn't want to do it again. He's picked up a Super Soaker, the Paddle Star, not going to quite land as DRX, they don't exactly have high health bars. But Deft is very healthy and there is no Darmon 80 carry left on this map. As they really want to deny this Infernal Soul. Teleport to come forward from the Sylas. Chovy will be back up to full health. Noggery, the same situation. Showmaker from over the wall doesn't find the trouble bubble. This Beryl gets taken out extremely low. The dragon's actually helping out. A Showmaker gets rid of the Trundle, so there are no smites for this particular fight. Moonlight Vigil goes absolutely wide. Noggery flashes forward.
Oh.
Triple kill instantly. I thought they nerfed the AoE on the Battle Star.
Nope.
It doesn't matter. As Chovy wants to fight Noggery as best he can, but Showmaker's still looming, and Doran going to be blocked off from trying to help out his mid laner. And Arrow sails by majestically as Chovy's going to go golden and then have a bit of a gray screen. No, actually able to survive for the minute as Doran comes in, gets lit on fire, and runs away. This game's super weird, Valdez. Guystrike not going to quite be enough as thankfully there is an abscond. And okay, here's the Infernal Soul from Darmon. Baron's going to be up in 2 minutes' time as Shrinkers have a field day. As the arrow is going to be avoided, Canyon tries to get in there but not able to find a kick that he really wanted. Doran gets on top of Showmaker. Ghost is going to be missed by that Moonlight Vigil. It's 1-for-1 thus far as the Aphelios is at least still alive, but he's going to be put to sleep. He's a bit tired as the Sky Strike comes in, almost kills him outright. As now Chovy, he grabbed himself an arrow and he throws it back to its maker. And Doran has teleport, as does Noggery, but the cannon really wants to be starting off a team fight and not waiting in a side lane as Pillar is going to go up. Ulti comes down, Beryl is actually going to avoid it, but has to walk back.
into DRX. Deft finds himself a Caitlyn. And Pyosik is just dead. Ghost has a lot of arrows to come out of that bow when you press your Q button. As this Elder is, in fact, what they're going to be fighting over. Bubble is going to go wide as Pyosik gets chunked to high heaven. Exhausted as well.
Nice health.
Yeah, Kerry is trying to get in there, but Showmaker's going to have another bubble pretty soon. Stand behind, beside me is going to be there for Kerry, so he does get himself over that wall, as you can see. They're getting corralled like cattle right now, Valdez.
Yeah.
Being told that they're not allowed to be anywhere near this Elder Dragon. And I think it's going down far faster than they think. As Bubble, once again, not going to find the target. Oh, the arrow comes in right as the dragon is falling down. This should be the last team fight as Pyosik is tanking for quite a long time. Subjugate onto the Volley Bear is very valuable, but not valuable enough, as you can see. As in goes Doran, he's looking to get onto Ghost, but Ghost just walked right past him.
He killed
and now, yeah, Trovi's in a whole host of trouble. Showmaker is going to fall, but the man drop comes in. Barrel, oh, taken down by the Chain Lash. All right, Trovi needs a bit more respect than that, my friend. Here for Trovi, can he defend? 7 seconds on Pyosik, 9 on Deft, as they've taken down the first Nexus turret. Trovi down to about half. Kingslayer does do a lot of work as his Zhonya's is in. And now Deft's going to turn up, but they're looking to try and race this one down, and it's going to work out here. So we have an even game. It has a lot to do with, you know, the fact that Showmaker just did 37,600 damage in 31 minutes.
That was CRX versus Tamon Gaming, game number 2, and Tamon Gaming tied up the series by winning this game number 2. This time, Chovy played Sylas. Twisted Fate got banned out in the early phase of Bennett Pick, so that was one of the options open for DRX. Tamon Gaming went with a very confident Zoe pick, and DRX completed their comp with Sylas. Sylas is a really good champion into the Tamon Gaming playstyle because they are always open to have fights all around the map. Han was pretty sure that this angry Showmaker will show something on Zoe, because he doesn't really believe that Sylas is not a really good pick into Zoe, because the hijack ults doesn't really mean anything or doesn't really get a lot of value away from Zoe. In general, DRX, they have a very high burst damage in the MT fight. So it was a huge clash between two teams that really love to fight. But we had a lot of huge accidents happening all throughout the lanes in the early phase. As Peter mentioned, yeah, we had a huge fight and very extended one around this blue buff. First, Tamon Gaming, they spotted Trundle with this Ash Hawk that he was coming down for this blue buff. And Zoe was the only mid laner who can roam down to the mid lane. Zoe had the mid lane priority, so he was shoving in the wave. So Ash, he also pushes lane really hard and instantly opens fight as he hit level 6. I mean, this is a huge win trade for Tamon Gaming, and Zoe came for a potential turret dive, and knowing that Trundle is in a really close proximity, he doesn't really extend forward to that. But they were keep zoning out Trundle away from this blue camp, because a lot of Tamon Gaming players were having a huge priority in lane, and also Zoe was already in this jungle. There was no way for Pyosik to actually just hover around that jungle. Well, it is true that Kennen had a lot of CS lead, but he already used his TP to come back to lane, so Noguri had the TP priority as well. So there was no reason for TRX to stay in that position and extend the fight. They could rather just escape away from it. TRX was being a little bit emotional, answering to the enticed coming from Tamon Gaming. Later on, we had a very surprising outplay coming from Damwon Gaming. They were earning all the possible lead in all three lanes. So Damwon Gaming, they spotted carry out, recalling to base. So they were maybe counting down the recall timer and then thought that Aphelios will be alone in lane. This was a very risky turn to take, but anyway, Barrel just jumped in with his ult. But it was actually turned out that it was a 2v2 fight, but somehow Barrel picks up a kill on Aphelios. That was a very risky play coming out from Barrel, but ended up being an outplay. And then look at this 2v moving forward and looking for a kill onto Ghost for so many times. It is actually really critical for Silas to miss one of his ability during a fight, so as he missed some of his ability, he could have just backed and returned to his base, but Chovy once again was being a little bit emotional, looking for a kill onto Ghost for several times, but Ghost just casually sidestepped all away from all of his skill shots and then actually got a turn around kill onto Silas. It was a very bloody and stylish fight coming back and forth from Damwon Gaming and GRX, but Damwon Gaming was the one that got all the wins. And the POG will be Showmaker on Zoe, as everyone would have expected. 20 KDA in this game. Showmaker, he used to take Unsealed Spellbook and use TP to give a lot of pressure in the mid phase of the game, but this time around he was Airy and Ignite, which means that he's gonna have a lane kingdom and have a control all around the map based on his prowess. With this aggressive rune choice and also spell choice from Showmaker, we can actually read that Damwon Gaming, they were really looking for a very bloody and volatile game. And look how Zoe used his flash for a potential engage. That was a really bold and stylish game performance coming out from Showmaker and Zoe. It goes also the master class of kiting up against Silas in the bottom lane. He also was able to pick up 2 votes for this POG from the media voters. And let's check out the final winner of game number 3, the Decider 1.